Hi, welcome back. Today, we're going to be discussing the differences between ex post and ex ante finance. Sounds confusing, but guess what? It's not. I'll break it down as easy as possible so you can understand. Let's go. As the financial losses accrued due to natural disasters continue to rise, developing countries experienced the greatest impacts. Natural hazards generate significant economic risk and create major budget instability for small island developing states like the Caribbean. Climate and disaster risk financing and insurance help countries ensure that their populations are financially protected in the event of a disaster. The two main methods that CDRFI use are ex-ante and ex-post finance. Simply put, ex-ante risk financing instruments are employed to help governments and individuals mitigate the financial impacts before natural hazards occur, and for which the government makes the necessary expenditures beforehand. There are three basic tenets associated with ex-ante finance: risk reduction investments, risk transfer, and forecast-based finance. Risk reduction investments can focus on climate-proof housing or infrastructure. These come from budget allocations, which means allocating a set amount of funds in the event of a natural disaster to offset recovery costs. Funds from development partners, such as the Green Climate Fund and traditional development finance, the IDA or IBRD, regional development banks, PBAs, and trust funds. Risk transfer involves insurance for public assets, natural resource insurance, sovereign risk insurance and regional insurance pools, social protection, MISO and micro insurance, takaful and insurance-linked instruments, which include catastrophe bonds. Forecast-based finance focuses on early action or response finance dispersed based on a forecast of an event. Currently, no governments use forecast-based finance. On the other hand, ex-post finance refers to instruments employed after a natural hazard occurs, meaning that resources are spent after a natural disaster. But like risk transfer, contingent credit lines and forecasted finance are also used to assist in post-disaster recovery after a natural hazard occurs. Ex-post finance focuses on risk retention responsibility and risk finance. Risk retention instruments cover national financial instruments such as national emergency or disaster contingency funds, reserve funds, budget reallocation, and in some cases, taxation. While several of these resources may be arranged beforehand, they are spent only after the event occurred. Risk finance consists of external financing instruments such as WB's climate response window, contingent emergency response component, immediate response mechanism, contingent grants or loans from other development partners such as the CAT-DDO from the World Bank, humanitarian assistance, private sector responses. Recently, the government of St. Vincent and the Grenadines received $20 million in disaster risk financing support through the World Bank's Catastrophe Deferred Drawdown Option, or CAT-DDO program, to aid in their recovery from the recent eruption of the La Soufrière volcano. After the catastrophe, a contingent line of credit was triggered. Disaster risk financing and insurance instruments exist to meet the various financial requirements of managing disaster risk and increasing the resilience of vulnerable countries to disasters' financial impact. Developing a combination of instruments that correspond to governments' differing needs during pre- and post-disaster phases, including disbursement timelines and funding size, serves as a comprehensive approach to disaster risk management and finance. Now do you understand the difference between what is ex-ante and ex-post financing? Stay tuned to our series to learn more. Don't forget to visit the Caribbean Policy Development Center's Risk Resilience Hub for more information.